for you today, would you be a yes?
Well, first of all, the House bill is not going to come before us. The Senate is starting from scratch. We're going to draft our own bill, and I'm convinced that we're going to take the time to do it right. Speaker Ryan today said that he hoped that the Senate would improve the House bill. I think we will do so, and that we will come up with a whole new fresh approach that solves the legitimate flaws that do exist with the ACA, where we've seen in some markets insurers fleeing, so people won't be able to buy subsidized insurance, but it will also keep some of the benefits of the ACA. My goal is to actually expand coverage for those 28 million Americans who still lack coverage today despite the ACA.
A lot of people are struck by the working group that's been put together in the Senate to deal with health care. I'm going to put the picture up right there. There you see it right there. 13 men, not a single woman. Cecile Richards from Planned Parenthood tweeted about that. When women aren't at the table, we're on the menu. Senator Patty Murray, Democratic senator, of course. It matters to have women at the table, and it matters when they aren't. Why aren't you on that working group?
Well, the leaders obviously chose the people they want, but I'm working hard with Senator Cassidy, with our co-sponsors, Senator Mike Rounds, Shelley Moore Capito, Johnny Isaacson. We're reaching out to moderate Democrats. I would like to see us put together a bipartisan group to solve this problem of Democrats who acknowledge that there are problems with the current law, that it is not working well in several states, and Republicans who also want to make sure that we're not reducing coverage and we're giving flexibility. There's an issue that no one's talking about in Washington that's so critical, and that is if we're going to reduce the cost of health insurance, we have to take steps to reduce the cost of health care. And no one's talking about that. Senator Cassidy and I have in our bill a transparency section so that you would actually know what you're paying. And I think that would help consumers make better choices.
Final question. Can you support a final bill that denies Medicaid funding to Planned Parenthood?
That is an important issue to me because I don't think that low-income women should be denied their choice of health care providers for family planning, cancer screenings, and well women care. It's not the only issue in this huge bill, but I certainly think that it's not fair and it is a mistake to defund Planned Parenthood. But